Contact have a box, and you don't get out of that, but you have room within it. But if you use the arms constantly, then the horse leans against you, yeah? He has to understand that your connection gets better because you're doing this to the horse. He's very strong in his lymph nodes here, yeah? And so he has to kind of say, come, you can do it a little bit, yeah? Also, that the rider thought of the transitions being less pulling backwards, but really more riding the down and the up transition, more up and forward. So even though you wanted to change gates to the lower gate, you want to think of it as a more going forward aid rather than a stopping aid. You don't want to allow her again to do canter departs out of a running trot, because in the moment you allow that, she's already out of balance. So you don't allow it. Trot, 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 and straighten her, and now you canter. That's the idea. And keep her straight as an arrow. You want to think of her being straight, even though you're on a curved line. Yes. This is really what a half halt is. You're rebalancing him a little bit, yeah? Rebalance. That's it. And again, rebalance. And you go a little. Keep the connection. I don't want loose reins. Loose reins are not light. Loose reins, I call it, are empty. So you want to feel lightness comes because the horse comes up in the base of the neck, not just necessarily that he has to go down with the pole. So he has to come a little bit more up in the base. This may, did you see what just happened? The mane flexed to the side.
Yeah.
Now watch. Yeah?
Yeah.
Watch. Mm-hmm. Not yet. Not there, you see? Otherwise, if that doesn't happen, he's not yielding. Uh-huh. It did it, but there you go. Uh-huh. That's what it is. Do you see? He has to yield in that outline. So you, this rein has to say balance, balance, but let go here. Balance, balance, but let go here. And now you do it again this way. There.
It.
Keep the canter. Make sure your forehand is leading. Excellent. And one more time. Think that the forehand is a little leading. Think of the haunches just keeping your energy. Forehand leading, not the haunches. Energy behind. Don't push the haunches to the side. Rather than us focusing just on the mouth, what we're really focusing on is how can we install a better balance. So, you know, I try very hard not to focus on the weakness of the horse. What I really do is focus on how can I make this athletic horse better balanced. It sounds much more positive. That's it. Don't let him escape you. Keep riding with your legs while you say, the door is open, but no, it's not totally gone. You let him peek through that door, but you don't let him get out of that door. Yes. Always think your voice has to go with your seat aid. Say, wait for me. That's it.